Incidence versus prevalence. Incidence measures new incidence compared to all people at risk over time. Prevalence measures all diseased people compared to all people being studied over time. Let's say for 12 months you observe 100 people who do not change their diet or exercise. If the 12-month prevalence of obesity is 10%, that means 10 out of 100 people were previously obese. They began the year as obese, and 1 year later, they are still obese. Hence, the incidence of obesity is 0%, because there are not any new obese people. On the other hand, if you started out with 100 people with a normal BMI, and then provided unlimited cake and took away their treadmills, what happens? New cases of obesity would develop, increasing the incidence of obesity. Let's say for the first year there is a 10% incidence of obesity, meaning 10 out of 100 people became obese. For the second year, there's still a 10% incidence of obesity. That means that 9 people became obese. During the second year, the denominator is not the 100 people being studied. The denominator is the 90 people who are at risk for obesity. The 10 people who became obese in the first year are no longer at risk of becoming obese, because once you're obese, you cannot become obese a second time. After the second year, the prevalence of obesity is 19%. Who cares? Equal incidence and prevalence indicate an acute condition. If the incidence of new plague for the first year is 25% and the prevalence is also 25%, that means there were 0 cases of new plague before the study began. Chronic conditions are indicated by low incidence and high prevalence. If the incidence of diabetes is 1% per year and the prevalence is 40%, that suggests that for the last 40 years, after getting diabetes, people keep living for 40 years. HelpHippo, better than learning from Wikipedia.